Hey guys, it's Haff and I am back again. This is going to be the 14th and final part of my makeup collection. I was going to do this in two parts because there's a fair bit, but I'm just going to do it in one, so it's probably going to be a longer video. I will do some swatches, but not everything because there's a lot of it. So this is all lip products. So I will leave a link to the playlist with all the other parts if you are interested in looking at them. One of those is also lipsticks, but this is more like liquid lipsticks and lip glosses and that sort of thing, with a few normal lipsticks as well that weren't in the other container. So let's just get into it. I have, three lip tars from OCC. I got these from Tamara J. This one is Black Dahlia. Looks a bit weird in the tube, but these are only the mini ones, so they don't have, I might have to toss this one. It's got a split in the packaging, and it's coming out the side. Ew. Well, maybe I don't have Black Dahlia anymore. That's kind of gross. Lip tars last forever, so minis is all you really ever need. If you can see black on my finger just there, it's actually nail polish. It's not a dirty mark. So I also have NSFW, which if you didn't know means not safe for work. It's like what they put on rude videos and stuff. And this one is anime, which is a nice pink. I have this colour lip stain from Colour Sensational, which is a Maybelline line. This is actually pretty old. But this, you know, they look like a Sharpie. And they put just a little bit of stain on your lips, which is fine if that's what you're after. I have this Apocalypse from Rimmel. This one is in Celestial, which is a fairly basic nudie colour. I quite like this applicator, how it's got the sort of well in it. So it sort of holds a certain amount of product, not that it wants to focus very well. It's a fairly basic nudie colour. I have this one, which is actually from Revlon, I believe. Maybelline. It doesn't have any markings on it, so I don't actually know what it's supposed to be. It doesn't have a colour on it, it just says 510 on the bottom. But it's this weird looking thing at the top. Again, it doesn't want to focus. Come on, camera. Okay. Got these little holes in it, and you screw up the bottom, and it comes out the top. And it's sort of like a lip gloss, and it doesn't have much more colour than that one, but it's just a glossy version of that one, which is kind of weird. And they're almost exactly the same colour. Interesting. Have this NYX Butter Gloss in Raspberry Tart, which is a purple, which is why I like it. And everybody knows the butter glosses have got a great formula. I have a couple of these from Maybelline. They're, what do they call them? I don't have the label on it anymore. There it is, the Elixir. I thought that's what they were. So this one is in Mauve Mystique, and this one is Vision in Violet. So a nude and a purple. These are ones that look like a lipstick like that until you take the... They have kind of a weird doe foot applicator. They don't look much like what's in the tube though. So if you have a look at that next to you, more purple than what it is in the tube. And this one is just a very basic nudie colour. So you have several lipsticks all in the same kind of colour. I have a whole bunch of, probably have some more hiding somewhere, of these Chi Chi lip glosses. So I have six of them here. These are just mini lip glosses. I've used this one here quite a bit. And I think this one as well. But they're just various lip glosses, different amounts of pigmentation. Like this one is, has very little colour to it when you blend it out on the lips. It doesn't really pick up a whole lot of colour or anything. And then you have like this one, which is more like concealer lip. Like it's more opaque than this one is. I tend to just use them to slightly alter other lipsticks and stuff. I have this one from NYC, which I obviously tried to pan at some stage. This is in Bury Me. Just a fairly basic berry colour. Nothing special. Nice enough lipstick. The kind of colour I tend to go towards, that's like my idea of nude. I have this one from Tease. They have the best packaging. They're just, all their packaging is just gorgeous. Unfortunately, I got this out of, I think, a Lip Monthly or something like that. This colour is super light. I could probably get away with it. It's just a lot more light than I'm used to wearing. I should probably try to wear colours like that more often. I have this one from Milani. Their Lip Intense. I think this, again, was one that I got in. Because I used to get Lip Monthly. I don't get it anymore. So I ended up with lots and lots of lipsticks type stuff. So that's a nice bright fuchsia-y pink colour. I have this double-ended thing from CoverGirl. I used to have heaps of these. This is the only one I have left. I basically got rid of all the rest of them because this is actually my newest one. This is a very intense berry colour, but it's still slightly sheer. So you can kind of build it up if you want it darker. It's one of those ones that you put this on first and let it set, and then you put this so you get a glossy lip. It was what we did before we had liquid lipsticks. This is another one out of Lip Monthly. This is from Haughty Cosmetics, and this is in Give, which is just an orangey red gloss. And now it is time to clean my hand, because I have stuff sealed it. And the lip stain one was right there, and there's like no stain. Not very good in terms of stain, it tells you that much. Okay. I have this L'Oreal Liquid Lip Colour from the High Intensity Pigment line. It's actually kind of old, but it's still fine. It's kind of this bronzy gold colour. It's called Harmless. And it is a harmless enough colour. I have three of these ones. These are from Maybelline. I don't know what line they're in. This one here. This one's Mocha Glaze. This one is Wine All Mine. And the last one is Sugared Honey. So they're just very basic lip glosses. Nothing special about them. Nothing special about the colour, just nice basic lip glosses. I have this one from City Colours, one of their Be Matte lipsticks. This one is in Cami. This again came out of a Lip Monthly. It's a really nice purple colour. It is quite dry. I mean, it's a matte, so you kind of expect that. You do have to kind of work with it a little bit. It doesn't go on particularly smoothly. I have this one from Clean Colour. This is in Sandstone, which is a fairly neutral but quite sheer sort of colour. Fine if you just want a bit of sparkle on lips. Touch Frosty if you like that sort of thing. I have a couple of these. I might actually have... Yep, I have three of them. These are the LA Girl Glazed Lip Paints. I actually quite like these. I know some people don't like them. They're a bit like the Tarte Melted. Only a lot cheaper. So this one is in Koi, which is the purple. This one is in Blushing, which is a nude. And this one is in Pinup, which is a red. If you haven't seen these, they are basically like a little squeezy tube thing. They are very minty, and you only need to use a little tiny bit, otherwise they just go everywhere, because they don't like set. They're not like a liquid lipstick, they don't set. This one is from, what is this called? Elizabeth, Evelyn Iona, I believe it is. It's just a lip gloss in Lisse. My camera is just being a shit. In Lisse. Just, again, a very basic doe foot applicator lip gloss. Nothing special there. I have this one from Maybelline. This is Captivating Coral. Another one of their fairly basic lip glosses, except this one is in Orange. I quite like orange lip gloss for some reason, or lipstick. I have this other one from OCC, which had sort of gone missing. It's a little bit grubby. This one is in Memento. I have this one from Lip Fusion, which is not really something you hear about very often, but it's supposed to be like a lip plumper. This one is in Bloom. I don't think I've really used it. It might be one of those things that I end up decluttering this year. This year is going to be the year of getting this ridiculously sized collection under control. Lipstick from Coral Colours. I used to use Coral Colours all the time when I was younger, particularly their nail polishes. This one is in Mauve Mousse, which is just a really nice basic nude. It is very sheer. And it's got a gold, I don't know if you can tell, but it has a gold sheen to it. Touch Frosty. I'm pretty sure this actually came out of a Lip Monthly as well. I have this one from Dolce. I don't know how to say that. This is 903. This one came out of a Lip Monthly. This is not sort of the colour that I would pick if I was, like, going for a brand the first time. It's actually quite a dry formula. I don't know if it's supposed to be matte, but it certainly feels like it on the skin. Clearly, I haven't really worn that one. I have this lipstick from Smooch, which I picked up at Chemist Warehouse not that long ago. It doesn't have a colour on it, so I can't tell you what colour it is. But it's a fairly neutral brown, very much the same colour as the, maybe slightly warmer than the Dolce one, and glossier, much smoother consistency. I have a Body Shop one. I think this one came from Tamara J. This one is in, it says Colour Crush. It's sort of a soft peachy orange. with a bit of red in it. Quite a warm tone, quite pretty. Another Maybelline lip gloss. This one is in Mirrored Plum. This is one of my favourite purple lip glosses because it is a purple with which on the lips kind of ends up slightly blue, which I quite like. And this one from Model Co. This is one of their lip lacquers. This is in Morocco. Again, another neutral. I would have got this in some kind of beauty box. Smells really good though. Smell it as soon as I opened it. It smells fruity. So I haven't really worn it. It feels kind of like it would be sticky. I clean off my hand again. Some of these stay on better than others when one's trying to clean them off. I have a Calvin Klein lipstick. This one is in Orange 2, which is a orange lipstick, like a reddish orange. So pretty. I like that colour. Probably not the best colour for me, but I like that colour. I got this one of these. These are the ones with the flower inside them. This came out of a beauty box. I think it was Bella Box. It's called Sexy Lace Lipstick from Heng Fang. Mine is in number one, which was the purple one. You got to pick your colour. Except these ones don't actually have a flower in it, but I like the ones with a flower in it. And even though they say they're all supposed to be different, really they all come out the same colour on your skin. And it's basically just a very pale lip gloss. And they usually come out pink on your skin. Doesn't matter what colour you are, they come out pink on your skin. I have these two lip tars by BYS, which is a brand that you get at Kmart and some other places. This one is the Big Apple, which is red, and the other one is Barbados Bikini, which is more of a light orangey kind of colour. These are very much like the OCC lip tars, but these were like $4, which is considerably cheaper. I have this very sparkly lip gloss from LA Colours, and when I say very sparkly, I mean it's a glitter bomb, but it's all like really tiny glitters, so it doesn't feel rough on the skin, but it is very sparkly. You can see the little sparkles in there. I like it though, even if it is super sparkly. Not everybody's into that kind of thing. This one is from Medusa Makeup. This, I'm pretty sure, came out of a Lip Monthly or it came out of a beauty box. This one is French Kiss. And it is pink. But a very light, it's kind of like a light Barbie pink. Not a huge amount of pigmentation to it. Probably something I would put over something else because I'm not really into that colour too much. This is one of the Rimmel London Provoca Lips. This one is in Dare to Pink. Again, this is one of those like double-ended ones where you've got a colour on one end and a gloss on the other. It's a very neutral colour. I don't think that was a colour I intended to get. I think I wanted the next darkest one. Anyway, this one's from LA Colour. This is Matte Amethyst. This is one of their matte lipsticks. Clearly it's purple. It's not as dry as some of the other matte lipsticks. I don't know how matte it actually gets though. I think I've worn it like once and didn't really think it got that matte. Fifth Avenue is a brand that you can get at Kmart Australia. It is really not very good, so I wouldn't bother if you're in Australia. This is in the colour Covet. And see how messy that is there? This thing is so super duper creamy that it makes an absolute mess everywhere. I may well just dash this one this year. I've got to get tough with myself. This is a Gerard Cosmetics one. I got this one from Tamara J. This is in Buttercup. This is my one and only Gerard Cosmetics lipstick. It is quite a pale nude, which is not usually my favourite, but you can mix pale nudes with other colours to make a colour that works better. So often what I do is I'd put down a lipstick like this, and then I'd put like a lip gloss that's like super bright or dark or whatever, just to change the colour up a bit. This one is an LA Girls cream lipstick in Last Night, which is a super bright pink. Pow. That is what we call a pink. No getting past that. Okay, we're kind of getting there. I have this one. This OXX is another Kmart brand. They don't ever have names on their lipsticks or any of their products. They're super duper cheap. This one, as you can see, is a dark berry kind of colour. Not super opaque, but pretty nonetheless. This one from Beer Bombshell. This is Hooked. It's one of their lip glosses. This one would have come out of a lip monthly. It's a good colour though. It's a colour I like. And this one from Magnolia Makeup, another one that came in a lip monthly. This is supposed to be their matte lip colour. This is in Matador. It is super wet. I don't know if you can see that. And it looks more like a stain, like it looks like I'm bleeding right now on my hand. And it's the weirdest consistency. I don't know if you can see that. And I don't remember it drying down particularly well, and it's supposed to be a matte lip colour. This one is from Milani. This is one of their Power Lips. I know a lot of people don't really like these. I actually thought it was pretty good. Mine's in Pink Lemonade. Again, would have come out of a beauty box. I quite like it myself. I wore this quite a bit at one stage when I was wearing a lot of pink lipstick when I was going to beauty school, because we had pink shirts, so I used to wear pink lipstick just because it amused me. This one is from J-Cat. This is Miami Red, which as you can see is a red. It's not bright red, comes across more berry on the skin than red. It doesn't really look like the same colour at all, quite frankly. I have another one of these Vinyl Max lip glosses from Rimmel. I've thrown one of these out recently. Actually, I have two of them. I did throw out one of these. I have to try these two out before I decide if I'm going to throw them out or not. So this one is in Obsession, which is so pretty. It's like purple with sparkles in it, and these have huge doe foot applicators. I mean, look how pretty that is. Beautiful sparklies. I mean, purple and sparklies, they just sing to me. And this one is in Devotion, which is pretty light pink, but still super pretty. I have this NYX Diamond Sparkle Lip Gloss. This one is in Ginger Sparkle. So it's a gingery, very sparkly. Pretty. Another NYC lipstick, different type of formula. This one is in Mocha, which is a poop brown. very brown. And I have this one from Beauty For Real. It's called Kiss Me. It's one of those ones that has a mirror on it. It's like the old Gerard Cosmetics ones, where when you open them up, if you press the button on them, that has a light inside. This one's in a very neutral, just lip balmy kind of colour, even though there's lots of sparkles in the thing. It's not really too obvious on the lip. Now, going back to that Magnolia makeup, this is supposed to be a matte lipstick, and it's been sitting there for a few minutes while I did all the others, and it's still wet. It has not dried out at all. So if you're looking at it for a matte lipstick, don't even bother. If you just want a red gloss or a red stain, it's probably fine. But yeah, would not recommend as a matte lipstick, because it just doesn't set, so it does not work very well as a matte lipstick. Just cleaning off my hand again. Alrighty, we're on the final stretch here. I have this one from Mono Molar. These are the guys who do like the tattoo, lip type tattoo, eyebrow, long lasting stuff. This is the lip color in Sexy Red. It's one of those ones that you put it on and then like peel it off. Not my fave. I've got this in a beauty box subscription. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with it. I may well just toss it. I have three of these from LA Colors. These are their Instinctive Lip Glosses. These are all supposed to come out a different color on your lips depending on how you're feeling. So we have Mystique, In the Mood, and Emotional. I've not noticed that any of them are any different. That one's completely clear. That one's Emotional. And Mystique. And In the Mood. In the Mood is actually virtually clear. Just like a clear lip gloss. I don't know if you can see any of those on the hand. The first two actually have a certain amount of sparkle in them, and the last one, In the Mood, doesn't. It's literally just lip gloss. So I don't, very much gimmicky and not very good gimmicky. And if you're going to gimmick, at least make sure it works. So I have a Milani Lip Brilliant Shine Lip Gloss. This one is in Bare Secret. So it is like a beige. That's the only way I could describe that one. Beige. This one from LA Colors. This is one of their shimmer glosses. This is in Flushed. There's a lot of gold sparkle to it. It's a really nice pinky purple with gold sparkle. I have this one from NYX, which is another one of their Diamond Sparkle Glosses. This one is in Fuchsia Sparkle, which is very much a fuchsia sparkly lip gloss. This lipstick is from La Cura Beauty, which is Aldi's brand. This is in 78. They don't have names. That is a very basic nudie pink colour. Feels quite nice. I have another NYX Butter Gloss. This one is in Eclair, which is like a go-to for a lot of people. It's actually not my favourite. Wow, my camera's just not my favourite colour, actually. This is from Omshi, which is a brand that you can get at Priceline in Australia. This is in Black Orchid, which is an amazing, but it doesn't necessarily go on like super dark. You can build it up. It's a gorgeous blackberry colour. This is a clean colour. This one is in Ocean Streak. Super duper glittery. It's actually got a bit of the last... I mixed it the last time I wore it. But it's basically a very soft, very sparkly, bluey purple lipstick. But they are super duper soft, this Femme lipstick line. Very, very soft. This is from Mona Lisa. I got this in a gift box type thing, where a whole bunch of like more high-end brands were had stuff in it. This has got a lipstick on one end in this pink colour. Don't know if it's got a name. 215. I actually have a matching lip pencil. So it has the lipstick, and then on, which is basically matte, and then on the other end, if you want to gloss it up, it has, or you can just go for a gloss because that's super opaque and pigmented. So you get a choice about how you want to wear it, which is always a good thing. This one is from Glamouflage. It is their lip and cheek tint. This is in Sultry Sophie. It has this really weird brush applicator. I haven't really used this. It just seems kind of messy. I should probably try it out, but I also don't like the brush. I got this in a beauty subscription. It was one of those ones you got to choose which colour you wanted. The only reason I picked this one is because my best friend's name is Sophie. So that was the only reason. I have this one from Chi Chi. Again, this came from Tamara J. This is in Hollywood Wannabe. Look at that colour. The beautiful colour. My kind of colour, that one. And it feels very matte, even though it doesn't say anything on the packaging. Packaging is super cute. Super cute. This one is from Elizabeth Arden. This is Perfect Flamingo. I got this out of a discount bin at Chemist Warehouse, and it was super cheap. It was like $6 or something. It's a really pretty pink colour. I mainly bought it because it was Elizabeth Arden, not because I particularly cared about the colour. This one's from Colour by TBN, which is actually one of my least favourite brands, quite frankly. This one is It Started With Kiss. This came out of a Lip Monthly. It's like a copper colour. I think it's broken. Certainly coming across as broken, a bit wobbly, but yeah, it's kind of like a coppery colour. Might be another one that gets destashed this year. I have this one from L'Oreal, which is, they're like their two-step one. I don't remember which way it goes. It's got this lipstick on one end, one side. Is just very mushy. And then it has a fairly basic lip gloss topper thing on the other side. This is supposed to be from their Infallible Never Fail lipstick line. This is in what's the colour? Lily. So yeah. It says there is a mirror underneath. That's weird. What do they mean by that? How is there a mirror underneath? I know, unless they mean the packaging's a mirror. That's just weird. Anyway, let's move on. I have this one from Karen Murrell in Sandstorm. This is supposed to have a natural base and zero nasties. I kept it in the box because I like the box. Again, this is a very nude colour. It's actually a warm nude rather than a cool nude. And we are almost there. We have my two newest lipsticks, like within the last week, newest lipsticks. I had a gift voucher that needed using up, so I went and bought some stuff. So these are both Maybelline lipsticks. This one is Power Peony, and this one is Rose Rush. Rose Rush is an orange-red. They're not super thick or pigmented. They feel like they'll be quite light on the lips. And Power Peony is a super light Barbie pinky kind of colour. And then I have, the last thing I have, oops, I bumped the thing, are these three Ofra lipsticks. I got all of these in beauty boxes. I think they were all from Lip Monthly. The first one I got is actually my favourite. This is New Orleans. And it is a quite dark purple. Then I have this one, which is Mina. Which is more of a blackberry kind of colour. And then I have this neutral one, which is Laguna Beach, which I believe is actually a very popular colour. So that is it for this. I forgot one thing I was going to say, that was it. I have this sample from Mary Kay of their cream lipstick. I've had a couple of these. This one is in magenta. It's one of those things I should use up. I think I started using it. But it is just... these are kind of cute because they come with like this little doe foot applicator that you can use up the lip colour with. So apparently it's supposed to only be one application, but they actually have quite a bit of colour in them, and I think it's really more than one application. But there you go. So that is everything that is in my makeup collection. This is the last of my makeup collection. It will still be labelled as 2016, although this will go up in 2017. So if you want to see the rest of the playlist, that will be linked down below. Leave me a thumbs up if you like makeup type videos. Click the subscription button down the bottom if you want to see more of my stuff. And don't forget to click the little bell so you get notifications. And leave me a comment down below. I try to respond to all comments, and I'll see you in my next video. See ya.